Today we pause to remember the sacrificial love that shone a light into darkness, that bore life from such emptiness, that revealed hope out of devastation, that spoke truth through incrimination, that released freedom in spite of imprisonment, and brought us forgiveness instead of punishment. Thank you that we can now walk in the light of your life, hope, truth, freedom, and forgiveness, this day and forever. Jesus, our Lord and Redeemer, you gave your cheek to those who struck you, and for our sake, you endured much mockery. Grant that following the example of your sufferings, we may be courageous in bearing our own, and learn from you, for you are meek and lowly in heart. You now reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Reading of the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 23, verses 26 to 34. As the soldiers led him away, they seized Simon from Cyrene, who was on his way from the country, and put a cross on him, and made him carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including women who mourned and wailed for him. Jesus turned and said to them, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me. Weep for yourselves and for your children, for the time will come when you will say, 'Blessed are the childless women, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' Then they will say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if people do these things when the tree is green, what will happen when it is dry?" Two other men, both criminals, were also laid out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him there, along with the criminals, one on his right hand and the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." And they divided up his clothes and casting lots.
Thank you. A reading from St. Luke, chapter 23, verse 35 to 43. And the people stood beholding, and the rulers also with them. He read him, saying, He saved others, let him save himself, if he be Christ, the chosen of God. And the soldiers also mocked him, coming to him and offering him vinegar, and saying, If thou be the king of the Jews, save thyself. And his inscription also was written over him in letters of Greek and Latin and Hebrew, This is the King of the Jews. And one of the criminals which were hanged railed on him, saying, If thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But the other, answering, rebuked him, saying, Dost not thou fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds, but this man hath done nothing amiss. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Jesus' third words, John 19, 25, 27. Now they stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother and his mother's sister, Mary the wife of Clopas and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus therefore saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing by, he said to his mother, "Woman, behold your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Behold your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her to his own home.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Matthew, chapter 27, verses 45 to 46. Now from the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land unto the ninth hour. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? The word of God.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the 19th chapter of John's Gospel. Later, knowing that everything had now been finished, and so that Scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, I am thirsty.
beginning at John chapter 19, verse 29-30. Now there was a vessel filled with vinegar, and they filled a sponge with vinegar, and put it to his mouth. When Jesus therefore had received the vinegar, he said, "It is finished." And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the Gospel according to St. Luke chapter 23, beginning at the 23rd verse. And it was about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over all the earth until the ninth hour. And the sun was darkened, and the veil of the temple was rent in the midst. And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, "Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit." And having said thus, he gave up the ghost. The word of the Lord.
Saviour of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us. Save us and help us, we humbly beseech you, O Lord. Let us pray. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you have delivered us from the dominion of sin and death and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. And we pray that, as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his love he may raise us to eternal joys, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. To Christ our Lord, who loves us, and washed us in his own blood, and made us a kingdom of priests to serve his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion for ever and ever. Amen.